Hello and welcome to this tutorial on CNN for binary image classification. Till now we have completed these three steps: installation setup, importing the dataset from Kaggle, and building the model. In this tutorial we will fit our CNN model to images. To do that we have to import a library from TensorFlow.keras. Dot preprocessing dot image import image data generator execute. Here we are using this library to fit CNN model to images, image data generator. Now go to files, test and training set. Define two variables here. First one is the training data directory, training underscore data underscore dir, that is directory. Now right click here, copy path and paste. And second one is the test underscore data underscore directory. Copy path and paste here. That's it. Execute. So we have created two variables here, training data directory and test data directory. These two variables contains the path, training and test set. Now we have to rescale the images. To do that, define an object, data gen, that is data generator. Use this class, image data generator. We have to specify only one parameter here, that is rescale. Rescale is equal to 1 dot and this is divided by 255. Execute. Great. So here we are rescaling the images. Rescaling the images is very helpful. After that, processing will be faster. As of now, close this. Now we have to define training and test set. Training set. To define training set, we will use this object, this one, data gen, that is data generator, and we have to use a method here, flow from directory. Specify the directory, training data directory, this one. After that, target size, I will enter 32 by 32. Target size means reading size. So we are reading the images in 32 by 32 format. After that, specify classes. Dogs, cats. Then class mode. Binary. Look here, by default class mode is equal to categorical. After that specify the batch size. By default batch size is equal to 32. We will specify batch size is equal to 20. Now we have to do same for the test set. Copy this, paste, replace training set by test set. Here also, test data directory, target size same, classes same, class mode binary and batch size is equal to 20. So we have successfully specified training set and test set here. Now execute. Great. You can see here 8005 images belonging to two classes and 2023 images belonging to two classes. As we have discussed earlier, there are 8000 images in training set and 2000 images in test set. This is not exactly 8000 and 2000, but it is approximately same. So there are exactly these two number of images in training and test set. Let us check the length of training set. Same for the test set. Execute 401 and 102. Let us understand this. Copy this line, paste, multiply length of the training set by 20. 20 is our batch size here also, and execute 8000 and 2000. So there are 8000 images in training set and 2000 images in test set. And here length of the training and test set is equal to 401 and 102. This is because we have specified batch size is equal to 20. It should be 400, 100, 8000 and 2000. And we have this minor error because we have imported this dataset from Kaggle. To remove that minor error, we have to download this dataset from Kaggle. Then we have to specify exact number of images in training and test set. And after that, we have to process. As of now, just ignore these minor differences. Test set. Dot. Here you can see multiple options. You can see batch size, class mode, and all. 20. So this way you can see all the details. Now we have to train our model. Type model dot fit underscore generator. We are using this method to train our model fit underscore generator. Now specify the parameters. First parameter is generator. Training set. Second parameter is steps per epoch. By default, it is none. We will specify 401. That is the length of our training set. After that, number of epochs, 20. Then validation data, that is our test set. And after that, validation steps, 101 102. This is the length of our test set, and store all this into a variable, that is history. Now run this. Epoch 1. It will take around 15 to 20 minutes to process. So here we have successfully completed training our model. At the end of 20th epoch, validation accuracy is equal to 74.35% and the training accuracy is equal to 95.6%. So we can say that the validation accuracy is pretty good. The validation accuracy and training accuracies are increasing gradually. You can see here. At the end of first epoch, validation accuracy is around 60% and the training accuracy is around 58%. After that, these two are increasing gradually. Training accuracy 58, 66, 81, and same here. But after the fifth epoch, training accuracy is increasing, but the testing accuracy is not increasing. And at the end, we have validation accuracy is equal to 74.35% and training accuracy is equal to 95.6%. Now there is a huge difference between training accuracy and validation accuracy. That means our model is overfitted. In simple words, we can say that our model has learned too much from the training dataset. We can improve that. Let us see how. Go to third step. To improve the training accuracy, we can add more dropout layers here. After max pool layer, here also after fully connected layer, as well as we can change input shape. We can specify here 64x64x3 or more. I have specified 32x32x3 here because we have the limited resources here. We can change target size also and batch size too. This will definitely increase our testing accuracy. Here also we can change the same. We can increase steps per epochs and validation steps. So these are the multiple options through which we can improve the validation accuracy as well as we can minimize the overfitting. As of now, we have validation accuracy around 75%, which is pretty good. So this tutorial about fitting CNN model to images ends here. I will see you in the next one. Till then, happy learning.